This is your CBS 46 News update, brought to you by West Shore Home.
Good evening, I'm Sean Gables. Today, President Joe Biden and Vice President Kamala Harris made stops at Atlanta-based CDC, where the two got an update on efforts to fight the coronavirus in Georgia. The visit comes on the day the Biden administration says it met its target of administering 100 million vaccine doses weeks ahead of schedule.
Everybody thought that I didn't quite understand when I announced that we had over 100 million shots in less than, you remember when I said my goal is to have 100 million shots in people's arms in the first 100 days as president? And everybody said, right. Now he should have been more, why didn't they say more? Yeah.
The president and vice president also visited Emory University. They spoke there, also meeting with Stacey Abrams, along with a meeting with Asian American leaders in Atlanta following the deadly massage parlor shootings that happened on Tuesday. Today, the Fulton County Medical Examiner's Office identified the four Asian Americans killed Tuesday at spas on Piedmont Road. According to the report, all of the victims were women. Three were shot in the head, one was shot in the chest. New surveillance video from the store next door shows spa shooting suspect Robert Long stalking his target before the attack at one of the three spas. Right now, a memorial continues to grow outside of those spas. And for the past few days, we have been bringing you live coverage of the police press conferences and more on our streaming CBS 46 app and on CBS46.com. Remember, you can count on us to continue bringing you updates as soon as they break. Today, Georgia Senate passed a $140 million state income tax cut. Now it's on its way to Governor Brian Kemp's desk for his signature. The bill would reduce the amount of income the state taxes. The standard deduction for an individual would rise from $4,600 to $5,400, while a married couple filing jointly would rise from $6,000 to $7,100. CBS 46 is your vaccine team in Cobb County. Schools will leave it up to parents to decide whether or not they want their child in class to learn online or in person this fall. The superintendent says the 2021-2022 school year will include a five-day school week for both face-to-face and online learners. We have full details about online learning available on the district's website starting Monday at 5 p.m. Happening tomorrow, Confederate Landmark takes heat with groups pushing to have it removed. The Beacon Hill Black Alliance will be in downtown Decatur at 6 p.m. tomorrow. They're calling on city officials to remove a cannon near the county courthouse that honors the Creek War of 1836. The war saw the removal of Native Americans from the South. The cannon was placed there by the United Daughters of the Confederacy back in 1906. And you may remember the cannon is in the same square where a statue honoring the late Congressman John Lewis will be erected. His statue also replaces a 30-foot-tall Confederate monument that was just removed in June.
This has been your personal news update from CBS 46 News, brought to you by West Shore Homes, Atlanta's one-day bath remodeler.